Yes, students. Class 10th D, please have attention here. I won't start unless and until there is pin drop silence. So we are going to revise the brief summary you have done n number of times now, but even then we'll discuss, and then basic attention we will give to literary devices now. Fine. So, Dust of Snow, written by Robert Frost. Am I audible to all children, beta? It's a winter's day. In Dust of Snow, poet has firstly mentioned that it's winter's day. Fine. Treetops are covered with the snow. Fine. Dust of snow are the particles of snow only. If I take a pause, it means there is some problem in the class. Last desk. So poet was standing under one such snow-covered tree on that particular day. And which tree it was? It was a hemlock tree, which is not at all considered auspicious. Fine. Such, there are some objects which are considered the signs of ill omen. Stand up, Gitanshu. So, hemlock tree is also not considered auspicious. Doug, stand up. Stand up, I said. Don't show me anything what you are doing, writing or not. That is none of my business. You are talking, it means you will stand. Then, tree seems to have, it is like poisonous qualities are associated with hemlock tree. Poet, sudden movement of the crow, then it happens. Next thing is, when poet was standing under the hemlock tree, sudden startlement, sudden movement by one of the crows over there. And what was the reaction to that? Action was sudden movement of the crow. Dust of snow fell upon shoulder of one of the shoulders of poet. Fine. So sudden movement of the crow, mass of snowflakes fell on his shoulders. And it is quite light. They're not heavy, obviously. But there was some change in the movement. So sudden movement or arrival of the crow, falling of the flakes, it brought a change in the dull, monotonous routine of the poet. Fine. Otherwise, then he says, it saved my day, which otherwise have been wasted. Why wasted? Because there was no commotion, no movement, no action. So it was quite dull day. So when it happened, he thought that this action of falling of snow saved some part of my day. The complete day is not ruined. Clear? So that's why this act has a tremendous effect on the poet. Clear? Now, the thing is hidden and metaphorical meanings which are hidden in the poem. Crow and hemlock tree both seem to have they are considered negative. Fine. Crow is an uncommon bird which is mostly not used by most of the poets. You might have heard nightingale, cuckoo bird, which are known for their sweet voice, but crow has very harsh cacophony or sound. So deliberately poet has used crow, hemlock tree, so to create the negative effect. And when dust of snow particles fall on the shoulders, that creates positive effect. Fine. So it saved this day. Clear? So this is it in this poem. Now, alliteration is used, Peta, in this poem. What is alliteration? Daksh will tell us because he knows everything. He keeps on talking for the whole day. Yes. Can you repeat? Already discussed n number of times. Yes, then speak. We do not have 1 hour to speak. Searching here and there, and then you will speak. Yes, Peta. Words. You're not supposed to read it from somewhere. Please explain. Repetition of words? No. This is the exact answer. Yes, she has given. Repetition of consonant sound specifically. Write down. Alliteration is repetition of consonant sound. Which is consonant sound? There are 26 letters in English. कितनी बार कराया A E I O U ये vowels होते हैं बाकी के जितने भी 21 letters बचते हैं they are called consonants fine so any word which starts from a consonant if I say feeding bubbles bubbling in the bathtub which sound is overpowering B so that is the example of alliteration fine In that way, I'm telling you, बाकी के जो 21 है, they are consonant. So, alliteration used US poem में, can you give me the example? Has given my heart. You can write the example also. Has given my heart. H sound is repeated here. H is a consonant. Saved some part. S is repeated here. This is alliteration. Then, beta. Yes, that's it. Yes, Peter. Saved some part has given my. Robert Frost has given 2 points. Fine. In this second one is we will be doing literary devices also side by side and 2 points basically today. Dust of snow and fire and ice and all the literary devices. Which are present in these poems. Okay. So second poem is Fire and Ice. हाँ जी बेटा. Yes, yes, I'm going to. Basically, in Fire and Ice, symbolism is used on second poem basically because fire is symbolic and ice is also symbolic. Okay. Clear? So now second poem by Robert Frost. Am I clear, beta? Online children, I'm asking you also. Fine. Yes, beta, fire and ice. First of all, gist of the poem is that in this poem, fire represents, fire and ice both are used as a symbol. So literary device to use whether it is symbolism fine both words are symbolic of some human traits when a person is full of passion greed desires specifically unbridled desires means to fulfill nahi hui hai fine anger greed unbridled desires that is fire is representing that so fire is symbolic of Yes, beta, tell me. अभी जो बोला है मैंने फायर इज सिंबॉलिक ऑफ प्लीज पे केयरफुली ओके अटेंशन यू आर नॉट पेइंग अटेंशन टू व्हाट आई एम सेइंग चाहत कैन यू रिपीट फायर इज सिंबॉलिक ऑफ दैट शोज द कंसंट्रेशन लेवल यस मन्नत वेरी गुड Yes, Manat. Speak up, Beta. Speak up, please. Sit down. So, fire represents greed. Avarice is also greed. You know, A-V-A-R-I-C-E. Avarice also means greed. Clear? Unbridled desires, passion, anger, they all are symbolic. Fire is symbolic of all those traits. Second, we have ice. Ice is symbolic of, yes. Yes. Insensitivity, yes. Numbness or cruelty. Insensitivity means the people, ab aapko bahar jana, means the person who cannot stand quietly, that problem is with you only. Thus, leave the class then. अभी खड़े हो आपका ये हाल है. इन एवरी रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ एवरी डे योर नेम इज बीइंग हाइलाइटेड एंड यू आर नॉट अशेम्ड ऑफ इट. इनसेंसिटिविटी मींस द पीपल हु डू नॉट बॉदर अबाउट अदर्स प्रॉब्लम्स. Those who are cold-blooded, insensitive, emotionless, fine, they do not take care of others' emotions. So, ice is representing that nature. Hatred also, yes. So, these are the traits of ice is representing these traits. Indifference also. So many qualities are there, you can mention. Emotions are there. Then beta, fine, poet, in this poem, main idea of the poem is, poet says that the world will end one day, for sure. Firstly, he is very sure about it. Firstly, he tells that, he is not very much clear in the beginning that how the world will come to an end. I can see that's why you're disturbing others. You can also leave the class. I told you already the fate of your class is very blur. Reason being just 3-4 students. Those who are, you know, having all these qualities which I recently discussed. Insensitive. Insensitive they are. They need to comment upon anything. Any stupid thing, they need to speak only. And then they have followers, those who are stupid enough to blindly follow them in the class. Groupism banaya hua hai is class mein. Ek group hai, iska, ek uska. And whatever the leader says, the others, they start laughing either or they start following him. Teacher to secondary aapki class mein. So now this is high time, wake up. Concentrate on your parents are spending a lot on your people. You have done a lot of hard work to reach here. Boards, exams are just lurking. Within days, you will be appearing in pre-boards and then final term one of board exams. Very difficult paper you're going to get. So, poet says the world will come to an end for sure. But he's not clear what will lead to end of the world, fine? So he seems to show his agreement what people say about ending the world with fire. So he says that I favor those who favor fire. Which poetic device is used here? Alliteration, fine, in this line. So on the basis of what people think, poet believes that this world will come to an end definitely. But because of unfulfilled desires, you can say the people who are very over passionate about themselves to achieve their goals, they can do anything for the sake of achieving their desires. Those who are very greedy, they can do anything at par. So they will be responsible for the end of this world. But either fire or ice, then he says, after favoring fire, he says, but it does not mean if I favor fire, that ice is not sufficient. He says, ice is equally sufficient. Divya, stand up. Stand up and do not show such face that you haven't done anything. Stand up. Today I am very much particular in making you stand for the whole period. I do not want any explanation. N number of reasons are there. Listen to others, then you will be caught. No sorry and all for this. You are interrupting not only me, the whole class. So he says ice is also sufficient enough to end this world, right? So poet links these powerful natural elements, ice and fire, both are natural elements, with the human beings and emotions actually. So symbolism is clear cut used in this poem. So in the first stanza, poet shows his agreement with those who believe in fire. In next stanza, he says ice is also sufficient because if people uncontrolled desires can lead to end of the world, but the people who are numb, who do not have empathy and sympathy for others, they are also sufficient to end this world. Fine. So in terms of human emotions, ice means cold reasoning, hatred, fine, insensitivity. So after that he says, poet himself has experienced both these primal emotions of love as well as hate. So poet has mentioned that also, that he has experienced both emotions, and both can cause the end of the world. Clear? This is the idea. Then he ends this poem with this only, that both are sufficient to lead to the end of this world. Now the poetic devices used in this poem. First, I have discussed, fine, alliteration is used. Next one is, now I told you repetition of consonant sound is called alliteration. Now I am writing second one, that is assonance. Assonance is repetition of vowel sounds. Write down, sit down, Vidanshu. Repetition of vowel sounds, A, E, I, O, U, P, O, W, E, L. Spellings are written here, you can see. Repetition of vowel sounds, galat mat likhna. These are the vowels, fine. That is called assonance. Dhyan se beta, what's your name? Jasleen? Hai na? Dhyan se sunna beta, please. So, now the example of assonance is, I hold with those who favor fire. Write down this line. I hold with those who favor fire. You can see vowel sound is used in abundance here. Okay? I hold with those who favor fire. Aap dekho O sound kitni bar use hua hai. I favor those. T-H-O. Who? Fine. Three times O is used, so assonance. Then alliteration already, favor fire wala jo hai, that is alliteration. In the same line, favor fire, that is alliteration. I hold with those who, yahan tak assonance. Clear? You need to underline and highlight also. Then next is symbolism that I have already discussed, but you need to write that. Yes, beta, online children, keep noting down, beta. Symbolism is also used. Yes, fire and ice. Then beta, green and gold. These are also symbols. Fire represents, already discussed, bar bar nahi maine bolna hai. Fire is also a symbol. Ice is also a symbol. Green is also a symbol. Green represents? Yes, same. Yeah, mentioned here, beta. Dikhao. Book do mere ko. Fire and ice. Here it is mentioned green in my notes. Maybe or some other poem it is written. Fine, so that is fire and ice only. Okay, in this poem, fire and ice only. Then after that, next poetic device is number 4, anaphora. Yes, write down anaphora. Write, sit down, Daksh and Dinyash. It doesn't mean you are sitting that you can talk. This point now it's your turn. This side is talking. Write down this device. The same. that we'll discuss. पहले ये वाला लिख लो, then we'll discuss. Enough aura is there in this. Write down the explanation to this. It refers to the repetition of a word. Repetition of some word. I'm making you write anaphora. What is anaphora? It refers to the repetition of a word or expression in the first part of some verses. In the first part of some verses. V-E-R-S-E-S. Some say the world will end in fire. Some say. So some is repeated in the beginning. Beta, some say the world will end in fire. Some say in ice. So some word is example of anaphora. So anaphora refers to repetition of any word or expression in beginning of the verse or any sentence. Some say, some is there. Some say world will end in fire. Some say in ice. So some say, twice it is used in the beginning. Dover use hua hai to dono hai. You have to take the correct option here. So you will see. Clear? Next is personification, beta. That is visibly used here. Personification. Write down. When human qualities are given to objects. Yes, personification is when human qualities are, Manad, write down. When human qualities are given to objects, that is called personification. Here they have given human qualities to fire and ice, which is not a living being. Fine. So human qualities are given to objects here. So in the whole poem, personification is used. Here there is no particular example to this. If specifically you have to mention, fire and ice are symbols, but they have personified fire and ice also, because they are saying fire and ice both are capable of destroying this world. So human qualities are given here to them also. Clear, beta? Now, next is some MCQs, beta. Now, kya batao? Symbolism. When some words are symbolic of some other phenomena, fine, they are known as symbols. Like fire is symbolic of human emotions, greed, passion, unbridled desires. Fine. Usko directly nahi wo use kar rahe. They are using the word ice and fire, but they want to say something else out of this. That is known as symbolism. Any doubt to anyone? Mannat, bar bar aapka naam liya ja raha hai. Lack of concentration. Okay, beta. 2 points with literary devices we have done. Next time we test on Monday, or whatever we have covered in this week, test on Monday of the same week, okay?